What's up guys, this is Balázs from Racing Brick. Today I'm here to share another video about the LEGO Technic V-22 Osprey set. I already made a detailed building review and feature demonstration, and another one about the simple Technic hub. If you did not see them, then click on the link in the top right corner before watching this one. Today I will test the major construction flow everyone talks about, that turns the Osprey into some Gear 2 shredding monster. According to the reports, it is crunching on the 8-tooth gears like you do with your breakfast cereals. People ask me a dozen times if the gears are already ruined in my model, like it's supposed to happen immediately after you turn it on. Well, the truth is that it does not happen immediately. If you saw my review video, you could see that I was testing properly all the functions. I did run them for a while, tested them simultaneously, even tested the clutches for all functions, so the system was stressed at a normal extent. Let's take the model apart and see the status of those gears. You can fairly easily separate the upper section from the rest of the fuselage. I created a separate video where you can see how it can be done step by step. The video is available in my blog post, click on the link in the top right corner or in the description to watch it. Now we can take a closer look at those gears. According to the reports and videos I saw online, the lowest of the three 8-tooth gears is the one that gets most of the stress, so that one should be damaged first. Well, as you see here, there's no any visible damage on this one. These are the original gears that came with the model, I did not change any of them yet. Now let's see the one on the top side, for me that one also seems to be okay. The middle one is not that visible, but as I see, that one works as well, there's no slipping or grinding happening. So here's a simple test. Let the rotor spin and see if there's any visible damage on the gears afterwards. I had to speed this up heavily, this was 30 minutes of footage, and still no visible problem. After a quick disassembly, I can show you that the gears are still okay. Now you can ask me why all the others had that almost instant bad experience. Well, honestly, I don't know what they did to their models, but I'm not here to judge anyone. So, what can be the problem? To test the possible scenarios, I had to do some preparations first, so I bought 200 8-tooth gears on Bricklink to make sure I have enough spares to start my gear crunching test. As you know, there are four motorized functions, and there are four switches to control them. The two lower ones are connected to linear actuators, they have built-in clutches that does not really stress the motor too much. Additionally, if the three 8-tooth gears are damaged, that means that the guilty one should be one of the upper two functions. So let's see my main suspect, the function that tilts the motors. As you see, when we turn this on and the motors reach their endpoint, this linear clutch is engaged to prevent the damage. It is very tight, a significant force is required to make it slip. First I thought that this should put a high stress on the motor, but apparently it does not. Why? Because there is a worm gear built in that transfers the power from the motor to the upper section. That worm gear cannot be driven by the upper gears backwards, that means the effect that would come from that section actually stops at the worm gear. I don't say that doing this for minutes is very healthy for the system. Other gears and parts can be damaged on a longer term, but apparently this section does not damage those three 8-tooth gears. One remark, it is better to stop the engine tilt before the clutch is engaged, as that one leaves this whole section under high tension, and I'm sure it's not healthy on a longer term. I did let this function running for more than 15 minutes, and there was still no effect on the 8-tooth gears. So, let's see the other function that spins the rotors. If you remember, there's a tube with friction pins on both sides that act as a clutch under the wing. This is there to prevent any damage caused by the blades, and also to protect the motor. Now let's try to block the blades and see what's happening. Oh, that was way too fast. Only about 1.5 minutes, and I did not manage to catch the exact moment. Here you can see that the top gear is not spinning anymore, the power is not transferred to the top section, and it has an awful sound. Let's take it apart and see what happened. Here you can see the lowest 8-tooth gear, and it looks terrible, almost all the teeth are destroyed. If I remove all three, then you can see that the lowest one is in the worst shape, the middle one seems to have a single tooth bended, and the top one has no visible damage. Now let's add three brand new gears and try this again. Interestingly, this time it took longer, I guess because the original gears already had some wear and tear, although not visible. Right before we hit the 5-minute mark, this happens. Let's have a look at it. And yes, it is destroyed again. After adding a new batch of gears, let's take a closer look again. Ouch, this is painful to hear. I wanted to continue my test, but even after changing the 3 gears, the system did not work as I expected. First, it destroyed the gears literally under 15 seconds, then I managed to make the whole system stuck. I think the battery level was already low, so it was time to recharge them. But there was something else. As it turns out, there are 2 other 8-tooth gears in the system, and despite not having visible damage, they also had to be replaced to make the system properly functioning again. If they are damaged, then they can make the other 3 8-tooth gears get stuck more quickly, and they get damaged too. The axles also suffer visibly due to the load. So I replaced a few parts and went back to the testing. Now that we know that the rotor spinning function is the one that damages the gears, let's see how it can be fixed. An obvious choice could have been the replacement of the friction pins with frictionless ones in that connection under the wing, but unfortunately that connection does not have enough friction after the change to drive the rotors. Now let's see the fix that was published by Hugh from Brickset. He removed one of the 3 L bars and added 3 more gears to the system. This way the power is transferred through more gears and the stress should be distributed more evenly. Let's test this solution. The good news? The gears won't be destroyed this time, at least not in the original way. The bad news? The system will still fail. In less than 3 minutes something went wrong and the awful cracking started again. After taking this section apart, you can see that the gears are not crushed this time, although they have some slight damages. Let's try to capture what happens. Time to replace all 6 gears. I try to get as close to the gears with the camera as possible to see what happens. If we speed it up a little bit, you can see how that gear in the middle moves forward slowly. At one point it simply slides off the axle and makes the whole system stuck. Here you can see how the gear comes off the axle and it is more damaged this time. Unfortunately, due to the structure of the gearbox, it is not possible to close the 2 ends of the axle, so this will happen if the system is stressed. This means the potential quick fix did not really fix the problem, unfortunately. I stumbled upon another solution on Eurobricks, and I tried to improve it a little bit. It uses 5 module long half beams on both ends, and the 6 gears are located in between them. This setup should give a bit more stability as the axle is supported on both ends. I did run this configuration for about 10 minutes, so it seems to be more effective than the other one. You can find additional photos of this replacement assembly in my blog post, the link is in the description. I still don't think that this will be the ultimate solution, as that middle section is still floating freely and does not have enough support. I am planning to do another iteration of the build with some improvements, and focusing also on a build that uses parts that are already available from LEGO. So, what is my conclusion? First of all, if you operate the functions carefully, and you don't let the system run over the endpoints or you don't block the blades, then there's a low chance to have your gears destroyed anytime soon. That does not mean, unfortunately, that the build is not flawed. There are safety clutches built in that are supposed to prevent injury but also internal damage, and apparently the latter did not succeed. The problematic part is obviously the rotor spinning function. There is no quick and easy solution to add the better clutch system, so the solution seems to be to redesign how the power is transmitted by the 8-tooth gears. I showed you one solution that seems to work, but I will have a look at other possibilities going forward. I'm still unsure how this problem could be overlooked by LEGO's quality control, and we won't know if it have anything to do with the decision to cancel the set. I still think it is a cool and playable tiltrotor aircraft. Stay tuned for the next video when I will try to build it using the Technic hub and parts already available. Let me know your thoughts in the comments. If you like this video, then please give it a thumbs up. You can also subscribe and tap the notification bell if you don't want to miss my Technic reviews and other LEGO RC videos. See you next time, bye bye.